Hi, welcome to episode 16 of Sketch with Jeff. As always, it's great to see you. You know, today I've been thinking about small and big. Why? Because some artists like to draw or make their art really small, and some artists like to make their art really big. Over the years, there have been some really big works of art in the Guggenheim Museum. Look at these 10 enormous paintings by the artist Hilma af Klint. Several years ago, there was even a work of art featuring cars hanging down from the ceiling of the museum. I also love small artworks too. Look at this small drawing of a monkey that the artist used as preparation for making a bigger painting. And I'll never forget these small clay sculptures that were on display a few years ago. They filled the whole area of the museum, and they were really, really fun to look at. Wouldn't it be fun to be able to switch sizes sometimes? To be able to be very, very big when you want, or then become very, very small? I wonder what my friend Pencil would rather be, small or big? What do you think, Pencil?
I want to be very big. I'm bigger than the Guggenheim.
You know, talking about big and small has given me a great idea for a drawing. I think I want to draw something on my drawing wall. Come with me and I'll show you what I mean. Come on. Okay, I'm here at my drawing wall and I'm going to try to draw something that's really, really tiny, but I'm going to make it very big on my paper. I have this very tiny seashell. It's so small, and somehow we kept it as a souvenir. I'm going to look very closely at it and see if I can draw it very big on this paper. I'm going to actually start off by sketching it with crayon. Forget about the little crayon. I'm going to go big. I'm going to look closely at all the little curves and bends of the shell. When I'm trying to draw something complicated, I like to break it down into simple shapes. I just look at the separate parts, and then it'll help me draw the whole thing. I'm noticing that adding darks and lights will really help show the shape of the shell. I've actually switched to some black chalk so that I can capture some of the dark areas. Sometimes I like to blend chalk with just a paper towel or something that can help smudge it. Just by adding some of the dark areas and light areas, the shape of the shell is really starting to come out. It looks like it's floating, so I think I'm going to add a shadow underneath it, because in real life it's sitting here on the table. One good thing to keep in mind about shadows is they get darker as they get closer to the object, and then they can often fade and get a little lighter as they move away from the object. So drawing this little tiny shell has made me look very closely at the details, and I've realized that when you draw it big, it changes it. You can feel the shapes, the shadows. It's very, very cool to take something small and make it very, very big. Now that I've added in the darks and lights, I'm going to give it a layer of brown chalk to give it the feeling of the shell. I'm blending it in with my paper towel again. You know, I could keep drawing the details and the shadows of this little shell all day. I think I'm going to even continue this drawing after I stop the video. The spiral shape is reminding me of a certain place, a particular museum that maybe you've heard of. After thinking about big and small, I wonder, what does it mean to be big or small anyway?
Well, if you're next to something small, you might be big. But then if you're next to something even bigger, you might be tiny.
So here's my drawing challenge for you this week. I want you to draw something very, very small, but make it really, really big. Or you could think of something really, really big and draw it very, very small. I'll leave it up to you, and I can't wait to see what you create. And when you're ready, share your drawings with us. Share them at Guggenheim using the hashtag SketchWithJeff. I always love seeing your art. Check back Wednesdays and Saturdays for more episodes of Sketch with Jeff. And you know, if you think this pencil is a little bit too big, I think you've made a very good point. I'll see you soon.